So we are today with Martin van Ittersum from Wageningen University. So today in this symposium we discuss a lot about how we can define innovative or new farming systems to be sustainable and also for sustainable intensification. But in the same time we present the diversification as a challenging issue also to come with biodiversity but also with intensive farming system. So how you can deal in the same time with diversification and sustainable intensification with the simplification of cropping systems?
Yeah, good question, difficult question. I think first of all diversification can be desirable from various perspectives. I mean, it might be very helpful to manage risks for farmers because they don't put everything into one crop. So if one crop has a low price or is suffering from bad weather or extreme climate events, he has still other crops that might compensate. So that's one. The other, I think, is it's very important for human beings to have a good diversity of in the diet and of nutrition, so that is also important when that requires that you grow different crops rather than put everything on maize or wheat or rice. So I think it's important next to the biodiversity issue. But then the question, okay, can that go hand in hand with intensification, with sustainable intensification? In theory, yes, in the sense that I think if you have a richer crop rotation and a richer number of crops in your farms, it can help to keep your productivity high and your resource use efficiency high and also achieve high yields. And it's good for the environment in principle also, I believe, when you rotate different crops. But at the same time, I think a huge challenge is that usually the market and the prices that follow from markets drive farmers into a certain specialization. And I think that's the huge dilemma. Farmers may want to diversify, but if one or two crops are much more profitable than other crops, he automatically is trying to grow as much of those profitable crops as possible. So I think that's the big challenge. In principle, diversification, I think, is good for many things. But economic forces often push farmers towards specialization. At least that's what I definitely see in Northwest Europe and probably also in developing countries.
Okay. Do you have any example of success story about this? I mean, by making diversification but also by increasing production or profitability for farmers?
Well, I think the idea of crop rotation has always been very prominent in the Netherlands. And why is that? Because the Netherlands' best crops for farmers are usually root and tuber crops, like potatoes, like sugar beet, like onions, like carrots. And you cannot grow these crops more than once in, say, 4 to 6 years because of all kinds of soil-borne diseases, soil structure. So it's actually beneficial to have a good crop rotation with cereals and with maybe rapeseed or legume crops. But what we've seen over the past 10 years or so is that farmers scale up, they become bigger, larger, and they try to rent land from dairy farms or from other farms in the country. And every year they rent a different piece of land and they grow as much of the cash crops as possible on that piece of land. So the idea of crop rotation in that sense is a bit, it's changing. And you see a specialization of the farms for the most profitable crops. And I think behind that is that economic force that farms pushes towards this. Okay. And for me, that's probably the biggest challenge.
The last question is regarding this symposium and what we are doing here by on designing new cropping systems. Do you think that a big of effort is already done, or we need to make big of effort to come with a clear methodology to design new cropping system. I mean, if already it's already we have a clear research about this issue on designing new cropping systems or farming system to make the system more sustainable.
And and you're pointing at diversification, or can it be?
It can be more. I mean, we know now we have a big challenge regarding the food security issue and to meet food demand. Mm. But also, we have to intensify the system. That means we have to design the system. So, if we take the problem by looking for the methodology and approaches that you use to propose alternatives, I mean, if you can give us your point of view, if there is a lot of research on this issue and...
Well, yeah, I think a lot is going on and we can already do a lot. It's not that we have to develop many more new methods before we can do something. We can start to do something, I believe. But at the same time, we also need new methods to do better work in the future. The important relationship for me that needs to be investigated is, okay, we need to produce more, we need to do that efficiently, and locally we need to take care of the environment. So the local emissions, that's what's important. And maybe the fourth dimension is, how do we maintain our farmers in business, and that we not end up just with a few large farms or maybe no interest in farming anymore. So those four issues, I think, need to be investigated more simultaneously than we do now. Usually we focus on two issues, maybe production and efficiency, and we forget about the local emissions and we forget about viability of the farms. And I think methods that can help to address the four issues together, for me, would be a real strong point for the future.
Okay, thank you. Merci.